429 years ago, a 9-time Grand Anatomy and winner, with a Guinness World Record and a record for the longest running number one ever by any Brit in Redditch, England, a sparkly dancing man named Harry Styles was born.
No, your eyes do not deceive you. I'm not Lindsay with an A. Because this is the Harry Styles birthday special, and this is the Stan Report. Harry Styles' 28th year has been his most successful year in his solo career, resulting in having 7 nominations and is performing at the Grammys on Sunday. He's captured the hearts of men, women, non-binary folks, sisters, brothers, mothers, fathers, babies, elders. He has become a household name this year. Whether you connect it to his former band, One Direction, or the phenomenal performer he is, or the fashion icon that he is, or that one song you've heard for the 6th time in your 8-hour shift and you're so tired of it you've heard of his name. I know he's had me wrapped around his finger for 13 years and...
What are you doing?
Let me have this. No, sorry. I gave you your own section to just like let this out. You do not need to take over the entire show. All right, I have stuff to report on. The 1975 literally just performed their self-titled album and Netflix is trying to kill itself. Get this out of my face. I was 10 years old. How was I supposed to know it would come to this?
Don't you see, Lindsay? It's 2023. The world is so infused with running on hatred. Every ounce of energy by these guys is to pick and pry at the depths of the internet to try and find any cancel-worthy information. We can't have a, what did you call it?
Sparkly dancing man.
This sparkly dancing man. Yeah, what's he do? Dance? Spread kindness? Want the world to be a more loving place? I can't show the people that. It'll sink into them. They'll start getting ideas, like letting guys paint their nails or wear dresses on the cover of Vogue. Before you know it, women will be taken seriously as musical consumers. And then what? Chaos, I suppose, this day and age.
But aren't you tired of it all?
Of what?
Tired of society's eventual or automatic response being hatred, the fear of oblivion, and the fear of being understood. We get so sick of stuff by the time we get to know it just because other people's opinions seep into us.
Should we just search romantic comedies on Netflix and then see what we find?
Hey guys, welcome to the Style Stand Spot. I'm Lindsay with a Z, and this is your go-to spot for all things Harry. I also got kicked out of running any other part of the show, so I'm going to try and stretch this out as long as I possibly can, because nothing is as important this week than Harry Styles' birthday. This week, Harry Styles performed 5 times. This was also the last leg of his North American tour. Maybe? Finally? For Love on Tour, it started a couple years ago at this point. And he told us it was his last leg a couple times, or last North American show a couple times. Well, who's to say? Do we know anymore? That's the real question. His 3 LA shows that he performed before his birthday bash were nights 13, 14, and 15 in Los Angeles at the Forum that he had to make up because he got sick, and then the new year happened, so. His first night back, LA night 13, he wore this French fry outfit, and I loved it. I absolutely loved it, especially because he wore yellow, and it was the first show of 2023, and I'm a little delusional Pisces, and my favorite color is yellow. Night 14, he wore this sparkly blue outfit, and it honestly looked kind of really comfy. Like, it just looked cozy. And night 15, he always goes out with a little bang. He performed in this outfit. And don't look at me directly. Happy birthday, Harry Styles. And then after his Los Angeles performances, he traveled, I don't know if it's north, south, east, or west, because I'm an East Coast kid, but he took the girlies to Palm Springs. And the first night, he wore another shirt sparkles and he looked fantastic. I've really been liking the t-shirts a lot, especially more than suspenders from the 2021 legs. Yeah, I like these. Keep them going. They're fun. And then his birthday show. His birthday show is incredible. I watched the entire thing on a live stream because that's what I do. And he wore a like pink Barbie sparkly suit, and he looked like he had the best time ever. I'm just so thankful that he wanted to share his birthday with us, with his fans. And happy birthday, Harry. I could talk for ages and ages and ages and ages and ages and ages. I need to stop, actually. And in final news for Harry Styles, the Grammys are Sunday. Harry Styles was also announced, which I know Lindsay with an A is excited about, and you know. Harry Styles was finally announced as a performer, and he's singing As It Was. A lot of predictors are saying Album of the Year for him. It's pretty solid Song of the Year. Dude, like, we're gonna go to commercial break before my brain, like, actually, like, phew. Harry Styles is touring in Australia next, so get excited for that. I'll see you next week, and we will be talking about this Grammy performance, okay? 'S up, guys? I'm Lindsay with a Y. Welcome to my office. I'm your Twitter friend. And I'm also siding with Z over here. So I hope you're not sick and tired of him yet, because we are going to be going over the top 5 moments in Harry Styles' 28th year. This has been one of the most successful, if not the most successful year of his life. And he has been the talks of the town the entire year. So of course there was phenomenal things that he achieved and done. Pieces into the story of his name. At number 5, this summer, Harry Styles headlined Coachella. This is Harry Styles' first music festival he's ever done, which is crazy to say. Like, crazy to say. First weekend, he brought out Shania Twain. Shania Twain is one of his all-time idols ever. So, this made me really, really happy. He also performed for the very first time both Late Night Talking and Boyfriends, and never in my entire, like, it is cemented forever in my brain watching him play Boyfriends for the first time. I wasn't there, of course, because I am an East Coast girly, but just the silence in that crowd of him just premiering this beautiful, beautiful song. Like, that song is still top 3, top 5, top of the list for me on Harry's house, as well as Late Night Talking. Such a groove. Such a groove. And then he followed up and answered my manifestations that I was doing all week on the second weekend of Coachella and brought out Lizzo. And they wore these big furry coats and were just bestie best friends. And I love them so much. They are literally the two people that keep me alive sometimes. So, 4 on the list. We have Harry releasing his 3rd studio solo album, Harry's House. I could talk and talk and talk and talk about Harry's House, especially because I had the privilege of seeing him live and him sing to me. Lindsay of the Z is coming into my brain right now as I speak. She's in there. With the release of Harry's House, Harry did an interview and got on the cover of Better Homes and Gardens, which is my all-time favorite interview he's ever done and one of my all-time favorite photo shoots he's ever done. And now I have a year-long subscription to Better Home and Gardens, and I'm so thankful for that. Harry's House also has received 6 nominations for the Grammys, which are on Sunday. This is the most Grammy nominations he's ever received. I'm pretty sure he only had 2 nominations and 1 win before this, or around that number. I'm really proud of him. I'm just really, really proud of him. 3 on the list, Harry Styles got a banner at Madison Square Garden for playing 15 sold-out shows, and also got a banner at the Forum in Los Angeles, actually really recently, just when he finished performing there, for 15 sold-out shows, and he is the only artist in history to have sold out 15 shows in both the Forum and Madison Square Garden. And it's really, really special to me. It is really, really special to me, especially the Madison Square Garden one, and I know it is very, very special to him and I. That is such an achievement, and I know it is his favorite thing to do in the entire world, and I am just so proud of him. And the residencies were absolutely something. We can talk tour and the culture and what happened throughout with the residencies of these 15 shows on another time at another place, because I could go on for hours. Performing is what he loves first and foremost. And so to have this achievement under his belt and made it is why it is in the top three of his 28th year. Number two in his 28th year is the single thing, the single key, the single spark that really like did it for him, was him releasing his single As It Was, which was the lead single on his album Harry's House. This song broke so many records but you know As It Was, I know As It Was, and I personally will never hate that song. It has its own touch in my soul when I listen to it. Nothing makes me feel the kind of warm hug on my heart as that song. I'm really excited to see him perform it on the Grammys. And finally, the number one spot, the most iconic thing that he did this year, it is 28th year, and I'm so sorry, but it's also like the most iconic thing that happened in the year 2022 pop culture wise as a whole. Everything to do with Don't Worry Darling. From having a relationship with the director to lies and beef and just words and only pieces of the puzzle that us as the public can connect, and then connecting it on our own, and just so many things unsaid. On top of that, the Venice premiere by itself with Florence and Olivia and Harry not even talking to each other, not even looking at each other. Harry saying it's a movie that feels like a movie. And then there was the whole he kissed Nick Kroll, which shut up. Just him dissing Olivia on the carpet. Dude, if my boyfriend ever did that to me, dog, they're broken up now. Who would have thought? I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. And then finally, Spitgate. Spitgate. For people that don't know what Spitgate is, it genuinely looked like Harry Styles was spitting on Chris Pine, who was bored out of his mind the entire day listening to Harry just talk the way that Harry talks. Just answering his questions that without actually answering his questions and running in circles and saying a lot, which I love him for, but that's just how it is. And so it looked like Harry spit on Chris Pine. Here's the video, hold on. It kind of does. Okay, I knew that he didn't spit on Chris Pine because he's such a nice fucking person. He would never do that. Especially in public, no, he's too media trained for that. He was on something else that day though, so. But I think the real story of the Spitgate is that Chris was simply just waiting to see if Harry would finally talk to Olivia now that they were in the theater. And he completely avoided her, which they're supposed to be dating at this time, and it was their first public appearance, and Harry Styles did say, I don't think I've ever been with someone publicly, so I guess he's forever keeping that image up. And though this year was breathtaking, I have literally watched his entire fame arc, the literal entire thing. It's been the watch of my freaking life. Behind his humbled closed ears, he really deserves all of it, truly and deeply. And for me and all the other Lindsays in the studio and all the people that feel like they have little Lindsays in their heart, happy birthday, Harry. Thank you. I love you. You truly, truly, truly have changed my entire life. Thank you.
Hell yeah! I'm gonna talk about Harry! I'm gonna talk about Harry!
This is my favorite part of the show, okay? This is my favorite part of the show.
I like everything else, but this is my favorite part. I'm so excited. I got my Harry shirt on today. And I got my Harry hat on today. It's Harry Griffin. And I love him and I miss him. Alright.
It shouldn't be hard to work properly. Like, at all. Like, this is literally the only thing that you need to do when you need.